Welcome back to the Newspaper Show with me. I'm Mendoza, and of course, Mark Walker here at Latest TV. And we're looking through lots of stories, both locally and nationally. And the next one is very much a local story. It's about new school for anxious children. An educational charity is set to open a new school for highly anxious and bullied children following calls from a resident. This is very strange. You know, we're looking at stuff now we never thought of years ago.
Yeah.
You know, children being bullied, children who are anxious, children with various degrees of problems that we've never, I mean, years ago, you'd say they're just naughty children.
Yeah. And it's a big issue because anxiety, because I know quite a few people that suffer from it. And, you know, if you're bringing up children, you can often, you know, transfer that anxiety, that condition to your children. So, you know, you can, because kids will pick up on anxiety. So it's not a good thing because it can really wreck your life as well. And I think a lot of people, some of the people I know, you know, particularly with the pandemic, have got really anxious about the COVID pandemic and not going out and kind of having a real trouble kind of getting on with their everyday life. So, and for kids to have, need to go to a kind of a special school for that, it's a sign of the times.
Yeah. I mean, you do have special needs schools or special needs areas in various schools, but to bring out a school just purely for that just seems an awful lot of money and just very, very strange. But, you know, you've got to think to yourself, should really you be integrating children who have problems?
Yeah.
But bullying, of course, is very different, I guess.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree. So, it might be a sign of the times. I think you're going to get a lot more cases of youngsters being diagnosed with anxiety and just because of the way that the pandemic played out and young people are really almost the worst affected, weren't they? Schools were closed, they couldn't meet their friends, so they couldn't have those social interactions which you would normally have at younger age, you know, the everyday interactions with people your own age, in your peer group. That didn't happen, so you can see it kind of expanding these kind of schools.
Okay, the next story, this is about abandoned vehicles and fly tipping is blight on our area. This is a story, I think it's in Brighton, isn't it, this one? This is, it's a disgrace to the town and local residents. And this is a strong message from a young Worthing resident who is growing increasingly frustrated with abandoned vehicles and fly tipping. And, you know, a lot of fly tipping, of course, has taken place because of the restrictions on dumping your rubbish at the moment. It doesn't help.
Yeah, it doesn't help. It happens a lot in Brighton. I know this story is with Worthing, so the problem's going along the coast. Maybe it's the same person doing it. They're moving. We've got cameras. We've got cameras on a lot of our bins, Mike, so it might be the same person driving along into Worthing. I don't know if you have cameras affixed to bins over there, but we have them over here. So, and you do get fined. You do hear people getting fined over here. Not too many, but I have heard of case this morning I heard about, actually. So it does happen, and we have enforcement officers, four or five, walking around town catching people throwing fag butts on the ground. But, I mean, your chances of getting caught are pretty slim, but still, we do have some kind of enforcement. I don't know if Worthing does or not, or if they don't, then maybe that's what the problem is.
I saw for the very first time ever an enforcement officer the other day in Shoreham, funny of all places.
Yeah.
So I was very impressed with that. I didn't know what he was doing. He was sort of standing there doing nothing anyway. I think when you're standing there with a great big uniform that says enforcement officer stamped right across you, I think people may notice him.
Yeah.
So they weren't doing anything naughty at all, but never mind.